Well, it's time to plant out everyone's favorite vegetable, and that has got to be a homegrown tomato. So today I want to show you how we can plant these in the square foot garden. I've been doing this for 9 years, and it works wonderfully. Believe it or not, we are going to grow tomatoes in 6 to 8 inches of soil, but that requires us to plant them a special way. Here is where I was harvesting, I guess, my first beefsteak tomato out of a square foot garden, and that was about 9 years ago. And so I just want to show you how we can do this. Now, if you're new to gardening, you're probably not starting your tomatoes from seed, especially if it's your first year. So you're probably going to the little nursery and picking them up already bought and ready to plant. But today I'm going to show you how I'm going to plant mine. Now, I started mine indoors a couple months ago, and I am planting one of my favorites, and I haven't grown it in a while, but I grew it a lot when I lived in Florida. Now, what we'll need to do here is dig down to the bottom of the square foot garden bed. You know, we have a weed block barrier there, and I'm just going to lay my tomato plant sideways, kind of diagonal. And this will enable the tomato plant to grow a root system, because tomato plants will grow roots from their vine or their stem, okay, which is a lot different than a lot of other plants. So because of this, we can lay it down on its side a little bit at about a 45 degree angle. Don't break your stem, and we are just going to plant it just like that, okay, and cover it up real good. We'll plant one per square foot. So if you have tall tomato plants like this, this is how you plant them. Just make sure you remove those bottom leaves. And then we'll just water it in real good. So I have already refreshed my bed, so you'll notice that I didn't add compost on this planting. And I'll just basically side dress it with compost about once a month. And if I want to fertilize it, I'll use a vegetable fertilizer. So I'd like to point out something very important here when you're planting tomatoes in a square foot garden, and that is your tomato plants fall into one of two categories, and that would be they are either indeterminate or determinate. And indeterminate is what we like to plant in a square foot garden because it's a vining type of tomato, and it will grow tall and skinny, kind of. You can prune it to where it doesn't bush out a lot. So if you grow a determinate tomato plant, this is more of a bush type where it will produce most of its tomatoes all at one time, so you can harvest a lot at once. And this will take up 9 squares in your square foot garden, so you really want to kind of stay away from the determinates or find somewhere else to plant those if you have a determinate tomato plant, because it just takes up too much room in a square foot garden. And when you're ordering your tomato seeds, it will usually state on there if it's a determinate or indeterminate. And if you're buying one, and I went ahead and I bought one at the nursery to show you, on your tag you will see it will say either determinate or indeterminate, so look for the indeterminates. So the other important thing about planting your tomatoes in a square foot garden is giving it some support. I love these little iron trellises. They're about 5 or 6 feet high, and I can just move them around my garden and give tomatoes and beans and peas support wherever I need them. I actually got these on clearance 1 year. Whenever you can find garden supplies off season that the box stores are just clearing out, you can usually find a pretty good deal. Usually at the beginning of the season, you'll pay full price. So that's just a little buying tip for you there. And I always plant my tomatoes on the outside edge of the boxes so that I can support them. Now, in your square foot garden book, they go into great detail on how to make your own little trellis DIY, and that one would be great. You can refer to that if you want to make one that's just a DIY trellis. So when my tomatoes get to growing, I'd like to support them either with little slings or little Velcro ties. Some people use garden tape, so you can just find some way to support your limbs, because once those tomatoes start to fill in, they are very heavy and they could break your stem. So I always give them some support. And one of my favorite trellises to use throughout my garden, all of my gardens, are these little arches. I think they're really beautiful. I think they give a lot of height to the garden. I bought mine at a place called Old Time Pottery, and then I've also ordered some on Amazon. And they are great for tomato trellises. I use them a lot in Florida for my tomato trellises. I also use them a lot for beans. And then, of course, at the river garden and my little square foot garden there, I plant tomatoes and beans up against the chain link fence. But that chain link fence is not very high, so I have to kind of work the tomato plant down the top of the fence and give it a little support there. But if you like the arch idea, I'll leave a link to a little video I did several years ago on how to assemble them, and I gave some more examples of how I've used them. And I also stressed how much of a pain in the butt it is to put these things together. So be forewarned, if you like them, you'll need about an hour to an hour and a half to put each one together. And they're worth it, though. I really have enjoyed using them. And so there you go. Happy gardening, everyone. And if you haven't already, make sure you click that little bell off to the right of the subscribe button, and you'll receive all notifications for my channel. Thanks so much for watching, and y'all have a beautiful day.